Hey man,
well,
it's like deep dive inception here.
Okay.
Here, I think you're gonna need this.
Hey, thanks.
What's up, guys? So today we are actually back with another deep dive. Today we're actually diving deeper into the Rainbow Cup by looking at Exequator. I do wanna go ahead and preface this video. I'm probably gonna mispronounce this name at least once in this video because it is such a habit to say Executor, I can't even think about how I normally say it now. Executor is how I, for some reason, always try to say it, whereas Exequator is how it's supposed to be pronounced, I think. Either way, I'm gonna pronounce it funny throughout the video, whatever. So Executor is a grass and psychic type Pokemon maxing out at level 40 with 15s across the board at a whopping 3014. Holy cow. With a 1 on attack, 15 defense, 14 stamina, at level 18.5, you can actually hit a clean 1500, which is great. Now, according to my spreadsheets and all the numbers that I have ran, Exequator should rank 79th in bulk and 65th in stat product, which isn't, like, super impressive. But we know that's not gonna, like, be an end-all be-all here. So, of course, all these numbers do come from his base stats, which is a 233 on attack, 149 on defense, and 216 on stamina, which, there again, isn't, like, the most ideal stat distribution for PvP, but, you know, we gotta work with what we got here. So, of course, the big talk about Exequator is actually in our moves here. So I did leave a couple of moves off the board just because they're not as relevant as the ones that are up on the board, if we put it that way. The two moves that I left off are both fast moves, Zen Headbutt and Extra Sensory. Now Zen Headbutt is a 2 energy per turn for 2.67 damage per turn. After stab, it does get bumped up to 3.2. It's just objectively worse than Extra Sensory. Because Extra Sensory is 3 1/3 energy per turn while still retaining the exact same damage, it literally is just better in any fashion you put it. Actually, even with Extra Sensory, I tried actually comparing Extra Sensory to Confusion for the deep dive, and when we go over our shields, I'll talk a little bit about how those numbers actually vary. But basically, Confusion is the end-all be-all psychic type move that you want to run on Exequator. Now, if for some reason you were wanting to use Exequator as a grass type fast attacker, Bullet Seed is your only option there, so I kind of felt like that was the most relevant other move to put up there. But I mean, I would say in 99% of the cases, if someone is running Exequator, it's because they are running it as a psychic attacker, not because they are running it as a grass attacker. Let's just get that out of the way now. Now let's go over the moves that I do actually have written up here. So Confusion, for 3 energy per turn, you do get 4 damage per turn with a 4.8 after stab. Bullet Seed is 3.67 energy per turn for a 1.67 damage per turn. After stab, it does get bumped up to an even 2 damage though, so I'm not super impressed with Bullet Seed at all. I really think it's Confusion or nothing for Exequator. If you don't have Confusion on Exequator, then I don't even think you should consider running it. But that's just my opinion. I'll leave that up to you guys for your own teams. So Seed Bomb, 40 energy, you get 55 damage at a 1.38. After you bump it up with Stab, it is a 66 on the damage for a 1.65 on the damage per energy ratio. Psychic Cure, for 70 energy, you get 100 damage at a 1.43. After Stab, it is a 120 on the damage for a 1.71 on the damage per energy ratio. And Solar Beam here, rounding out the end, for 80 energy, you get 150 damage at a 1.88. After Stab, it does get bumped up to a full 180 for a mind-boggling 2.25 damage per energy ratio. Definitely the most efficient move, but unfortunately it's also the slowest move. So out of these, I definitely think that Seed Bomb and Psychic are kind of no-brainers. Seed Bomb is just going to be so much faster. It helps with the shield pressure from Exequator, while Psychic is there if you need it. In some of the matchups, you can be, you know, hitting harder with Psychic, but I mean, generally, Bullet Seed's going to be your speed. Psychic's gonna be your damage. So for the actual moveset, which I will put up here, we do actually run all of our simulations with Confusion, Seed Bomb, and Psychic for the rest of this video. Briefly, I will, like I mentioned, I will talk a little bit about Extra Sensory, but it'll just be really fast to compare the shield scenarios. Speaking of, let's actually get into those. So for our first shield scenario here, we do have a 0 versus 0, which is where I don't have any shields, my opponent doesn't have any shields, kind of like a closing type situation, if you will. We actually end up winning 39.1%.
which is okay. It's not super high, but that's okay. Then in our next shield scenario, we do have a 2 versus 0, which is a 76.1. But I'm actually not too concerned about that. In this scenario, since I have both shields, my opponent doesn't have any, I actually want to know which Pokemon still just flat out end up beating me. And if you really sit and think about this one's not too surprising. It's mainly the Bug Bite carriers. Basically, anything that has access to Bug Bite is going to be able to tear through the Exeggutor really fast. Considering that we have a super duper weakness, we do have a big problem with the Bug Bite users, so we gotta have to watch out for that. Our next shield scenario is the 0 versus 2, which is where I don't have any shields, my opponent actually has both shields this time. We actually end up winning 8.7% here. And actually, in this scenario, these are the ones that I'm concerned about. If I actually still end up winning matches, even though they have complete shield advantage, I want to know which Pokemon those are. And to not really any surprise, if you know that Exeggutor is going to be used for a specific role with Confusion, he's going to be the anti-poison or the anti-Venusaur of the cup here. A lot of the poison types lose to us here, and there's a couple of odds and ends things, but nothing like super notable. It's mainly the poison types that have such a big issue with us here. So outside of that, that's pretty much it that we can win against if they have complete shield advantage. Our last shield scenario here is this 2 versus 2, which is where I have both shields, my opponent actually has both shields, or the opening type situation, if you will. We actually end up winning 47.8%. So what does that tell us? Well, since we have a higher percentage here than we do in the closing section, it kind of seems like Exeggutor prefers to open. Although it's not a very high number, so it's still kind of risky to lead off with Exeggutor, unless you literally see that they don't have any answers for it. It's kind of a middle of the road type of lead there. Now comparing that to Extrasensory, because I was curious, because Extrasensory is gonna give us a little bit more energy for a little less damage. I was like, well, I wonder how much it actually affects these numbers. So just for reference, in the 0 versus 0, Extrasensory gets bumped down to 30.4. In the 2 versus 0, Extrasensory goes down to 69.6. In the 0 versus 2, Extrasensory gets bumped down to a full 0%. And then our last one here, the 2 versus 2, Extrasensory is a 28.3. So it is worse in every plausible shield scenario there to actually have Extrasensory, which kind of like throws Exeggutor out the window for me. I don't have one with Confusion, so there's not really any hope for using it. Zen Headbutt would be just objectively worse in every scenario. Extrasensory is like the next best option, but even then in this cup, Confusion is where it's at. So now we're actually gonna get into some matchups with our Exeggutor here. So if you want to follow along on PB Pokey, you can. You can actually just do this for yourself if you ever want to by literally going under Great League Multi-Battle is the battle system that we're gonna be using here. I'm gonna set up our Exeggutor with our Confusion Psychic Seed Bomb, just like we talked about. We're gonna give ourselves one shield. We're gonna set this to custom over here. And then we're actually gonna go down to this quick fill option, and there will be an option for the Rainbow Cup meta. That will actually fill all of these meta relevant Pokemon in our battle system here. And then we also make sure that we give them one shield as well. So that way it's very even in both scenarios here. So once we hit battle, you can see here 14 wins, 8 losses, and 2 draws. So let's actually see these. So Venusaur, Raikou, Venomoth, Lantern, Slowpoke, Victreebel, Beedrill, Slowbro, Raichu, Blastoise, Omastar, Macargo, Typhlosion, and Meganium are all wins there. So some notable ones there are Venusaur, because Venusaur is basically the reason that we're running Exeggutor in the first place. We want that strong Confusion user on our team to combat that really, really strong Venusaur. So that's great. Then some other notable ones, I think Lantern is pretty interesting that we're beating it. Lantern could be like a budget version for like the Raichu or the Magneton if people aren't wanting to fork out the resources to have a legacy one of those. Lantern is a pretty decent option there. Slowpoke and Slowbro, which means that we are actually beating the other Confusion users that I do think most people are looking at, which is, that's what I think makes Exeggutor so desirable. It still ends up beating the Slowpoke and the Slowbro, plus it still ends up beating the Venusaur, which is great. The Beedrill, that makes sense. It does have the poison type move. Victreebel, gonna be resisting a lot of the damage it throws at us. Raichu's the same story.
Blastoise, not too worried there. Omastar, Macargo, Typhlosion, and Meganium is actually our hardest matchup. And considering that we're basically dishing out some neutral damage while we're getting hit for resisted damage, and on top of that, we don't have anything to actually hit that Meganium for super effective damage like we would with the Venusaur. Kind of does make that one a pretty rough match. So of course we do tie up against ourselves, and you can see that Kingdra is actually our other tie. So considering that we are going to at least faint in that situation, I do consider those losses for the actual purpose of the deep dive. But then we have Azumarill, Charizard, Ninetales, Magneton, Quagsire, Mantine, Lapras, and that Fortress down there at the bottom as our hardest matchup out of the meta. So a lot of these are pretty understandable. None of these are like too quirky. I mean, Charizard and Ninetales make a lot of sense there. Azumarill actually is a little bit weird. It's as tanky as can ever be. And it actually can hit us for some super effective damage with that Ice Beam. So you do kind of have to watch out with that one. The Magneton is also a little weird considering it's basically going to be resisted on both sides there, but that Magnet Bomb is able to actually push through some decent damage to us. It ends up making us lose there. The Quagsire too. If the Quagsire is actually carrying that Acid Spray, it's going to be pretty rough. So depending on which moveset they're actually using, like if we switch this to Sludge Bomb, let's see how that works. Still ends up beating us there. If it is by chance running the Earthquake variant though, it does actually lose. So there may be some more incentive for you to like go back to the drawing board on that actual Quagsire build you have and determine on which one you want to run. The Mantine makes a whole lot of sense considering it does have Wing Attack there. And then Lapras, those Ice type moves, and Fortress with the Bug Bite like we talked previously is going to be a really rough matchup. So now let's actually get into some of the types that we're actually going to be facing in the Rainbow Cup just to kind of see how we do widespread amongst those. This is what I call the countering section. Basically, these green ones here are the types that we have favorable matchups towards. Generally, I just consider if it's more than 50% of a win in that typing, then I would consider that a pretty decent matchup. Whereas if it's less than 50%, I usually consider that something that you want to bring to the table to actually combat it. But we kind of dive into the actual Pokemon in here to see what those are. So let's actually take a look at the electric typing first. All we're going to do is we're going to back out of that custom group here. We're just going to hit Rainbow Cup, one shield, still same exact thing. Once we hit battle here, it'll pull it down. We just want to type in electric, and then we can get all of the electric types here. So with the electric type, we only end up having a loss to Magneton, which does actually reflect the exact same thing here. Now, some of the things to note is for this actual section, PV Pokey actually chooses the most favorable matchup to go up against Exeggutor. So while we probably will see a couple of variants here, just keep that in mind that PV Pokey is choosing our hardest moveset that we're going to be going up against. So I kind of like that, to be honest. It gives us a nice idea of, oh, it could beat us if it ran this moveset, but if it's running what's considered to be the meta moveset, we could beat it. You know, just kind of a different perspective there. So the electric typing here, it's no big deal. Magneton being the only loss we have, everything else is pretty much clean cut. Magnemite can be kind of close, but I don't foresee people running Magnemite whatsoever. I mean, it was talked about for a little bit, but it's just not like something people are, I think, gonna invest in. Raichu kind of still pretty rough there, but in general, the electric types are pretty okay. Next, moving on to the grass types here. So we do actually have 5 losses and 2 ties. So let's see what those are. So our losses are the Exeggutor, okay, Parasect, Blossom, Jumpluff, and Tangela are all losses. So something to actually take note of here, this Exeggutor match is a little bit weird. So PV Pokey actually claims that we're gonna actually lose in this scenario, but this actually comes down to the way that PV Pokey is actually running this simulation. If we actually take out these negates from the fast moves, you can see it does actually end in a tie, or it would actually win with whoever has charge move priority. Now, if we have these negates turned on, it literally just comes down to just pure simulation wonkiness. I think that the Exeggutor should be viewed as a tie, even though that PvPokey is actually claiming it wouldn't be. I would probably say so myself as a tie. But Parasect, Blossom, Jumpluff, and Tangela are definitely losses there. The Exeggutor is a tie, and the Bayleaf is also our other tie. But after that, we're pretty solid here. The main ones being Venusaur and Ivysaur there are the biggest ones that we want to be targeting. So those are the ones we are proud of. Next, let's actually get into the water typing. So I have 16 losses and 3 ties. And that sounds like extremely high, but there are a ton of water Pokemon to look through here. So of course, some of these are going to be a little wonky, like the Suicune and the Starmie. But the Wartortle and Blastoise, if they're utilizing any kind of Dark-type moves or Ice-type moves, they're going to be able to just tear through us. Lapras, Dewgong, Mantine, all the same there. Gyarados is going to be probably pushing some neutral damage, or no, it actually has Bite there if it's running Dragon Breath, just because I'm curious. It dies. Okay. Anyways, now the Kingler, Quagsire, we've talked about. Cloyster, probably going to be utilizing ice moves. And considering that we're only going to have Seed Bomb, we're not coming out of the gate with super effective damage. We're more or less holding that in Seed Bomb. It does kind of make the water type a little bit less of a one-sided matchup like you would expect from a grass type. But after that, we do tie up against Tentacruel, Seeking, and Croconaw. Which the Tentacruel is the important one here. I feel like that's the one that's like got to be the one that we win. But as you can see, with it having those poison type moves, it does actually get to do some pretty decent damage up against our grass typing. So it actually ends up in a tie. From there though, it's Poliwrath, Seadra, Kabuto, Omanyte of course are there. Slowbro, you know, the water typing is pretty okay from there. I'd say it's really close to 50-50. I did count 16 losses and 2 ties. I'm pretty sure we end up winning like 17 or something. Like, it's extremely close, but it is more than half that we end up winning. So just kind of like, you have to kind of pay attention to which ones you can beat out of the meta, which ones you can't beat. Generally speaking, if they have access to ice moves, it's going to be a bad idea. If they have access to flying type moves or at least neutral damage, it's going to be a bad idea. Now into the negative side of this, let's actually look at the bug types. As you can see, we have 2 wins written down, which both of these are Ariados and Yanma. After that is a loss from here on out. Pinsir, Heracross, Beedrill, Venomoth, Scyther, Pineco, Parasect, Scizor, Butterfree, Ledian, and Fortress. Now the Beedrill, So we actually won against the Beedrill in the actual meta part here, but this Beedrill we lose to. Bug Bite. As you can see, what I was talking about earlier, anything that can carry Bug Bite is gonna do like an immense amount of damage to us, and it ends up hurting us quite a bit more than you would expect. But the meta version is actually probably gonna be running Poison Jab, which does allow us to end up winning there. So you kind of can see it's a kind of a difference on which moveset they're running. And our last typing here is the fire typing with 2 wins and 2 ties. You can see our 2 wins are Arcanine and Typhlosion. We actually have a tie up against Growlithe and Magby. Is it weird that Growlithe and Magby do better than both Arcanine and Typhlosion? Is that weird to anybody else? And I feel like Typhlosion should be doing some good work here, but unfortunately, he's not. Anyways, so from there, Rapidash, Moltres, Charizard, Flareon, Entei, Quilava, Magmar, Ponyta, Ninetales, Charmeleon, Macargo, Ho-Oh, and Houndoom are the hardest matchups yet. Now, Houndoom, we talked a little bit about in the team building video with Snarl. You can see there it does really, really good up against us. If you are running Snarl, you're going to win with 75 health remaining, whereas if you run with Fire Fang, you are going to end up winning with 83. So, depending on which variant you're running, you'll do pretty good with Houndoom up against the Exeggutor. So that is actually going to be it for Exeggutor, guys. Thank you so much for hanging out. Thank you so much for watching. By my math, today is Friday, which means that tomorrow we're going to be doing some versus videos. So I have a couple of those stashed away. I actually may do another two-parter. If you guys are... I'm going to start working on it immediately after I get done recording. So whether you guys like it or not, I'm already going to have it. Either way, I think I'm going to do another two-parter and compare a lot of Pokemon, kind of like I did in the last video. So we'll see how that goes though. So since today is Friday, all weekend long, you guys are free to vote for any deep dives that you want across any of the videos that come out. I won't even show you what's coming up next because if I say that, that's the next one, then by the time Monday rolls around and I start to do my actual deep dive-ness for it, it'll have all changed based on the votes. But either way, thank you guys so much for hanging out. Thanks so much for watching. Always remember that if you like to like videos, you can do that. But if you don't, you can be that guy. Otherwise, let me know what you have to say down in the comments below. And until our next video, I will catch you then.